Most difficult instrument to play. He thought he said, second fiddle. guys around him, a motley crew, fishermen and the whole crowd, and he trained them and he equipped them, then he sent them out to do ministry. And that's what Paul did with Timothy. Timothy traveled with him. And he helped him, he mentored him, he nurtured him. And then he was free after a few, let him go. He's a close friend, he's looking all over the place. And that's what ministry is all about, isn't it? You find something, you have the leadership, you nurture them, you help them. Then there's Epaphroditus, another one of his friends, who come all the way from Philippi without money to be with him and to help him and did this. So these two people are wonderful examples of Christian friendship. Jesus needed the same thing. He needed a small group. He needed a group of friends. And that's what you need, if you're honest with yourself. You really are. You need someone to talk to. You need someone to meet with. That's why the small groups in the church are vital. It's extremely important. So it really arises out of a genuine love for others. Now the social reality is this, and I've been in psychological field and all that kind of stuff, and I thank God for those insights. That's the social reality. Those people I've discovered who are only interested in themselves seldom have close friends. That's the social reality. If you're only interested in yourselves, they won't have real friends. We're called to be friends, as Jesus shows us the way. And not to be caught up with selfish ambition. Let me close with one illustration, and the kids are going to tell the story. Let them teach us about love and joy. It comes, here's, and I'll close with a quotation from Jesus, which was an all-beginner quote. It's a story which I read recently as one of many humble stories. You may have heard it, but it was a story told by a doctor in the United States. It was about a girl who was suffering from a serious disease, and the only hope of recovery was a blood transfusion from her brother, who had the same disease, a blood disease, but his body had developed the antibodies. So the brother agreed to a blood transfusion from his sister. And the time is going to take place. The boy asked the doctor, your brother, trembling, will I start to die right away? The doctor said, come on. He was so impressed with the boy's courage that he said, why are you willing to risk your life this way? And he said, and let them minister.